Hello, this is the RPG Chick. Welcome back once again to Let's Play the Book of Unwritten Tales 2. We just lost at Pirate Poker, so she has to stay here for a year, but she didn't give the princess's word of honor, so I guess she's not.
Critter will be alright. Won't matter.
Seen that?
He didn't even hear me out. He simply disappears.
Yep.
Excuse me, Your Honor?
Yes?
About Pirate Poker.
About Pirate Poker?
Yes?
No.
I haven't got time for games.
Oh, whatever.
I think I've interrupted the court proceedings long enough.
True. Now, where was I?
Off with their heads, apparently. Alright, this is back to the harbor where we were. Yeah. Okay, so we're going up here. Let's look at the hatch. What is this, air conditioning?
A hatch in the wall. Nothing.
Oh no. That's one hell of a puzzle.
A bottle, something like potato crisps, and toilet paper?
Huh.
Enermax, the energy drink, provides energy to the max, plus to endurance, minus to intelligence.
Yeah.
The stuff seems to consist practically of just water, sugar, and colouring. And now do I have to actually go and get hold of all this stuff just to get in there?
It heard you.
My feet hurt. It's too hot in here, and I've just had a row with my ex. Woe betide you if your information is not any use.
Yep, she'll kill you.
An energy drink bottle. Surprised I found one here. According to the label, the ingredients are mainly water, sugar, and colouring.
Okay.
The building's got no windows at all. This door appears to be the only way in.
What door? It's just something in the shape of a door that's really more of the wall. Oh! She teleported!
Nothing. I can't see anything like a door handle either. It appears that I have to get hold of a bottle of this strange energy drink, a few potato crisps, and toilet roll. Strange offerings.
Really?
It appears that I... Strange offer. It appears that I... Strange...
That's all the same. Where am I gonna find this crap? Maybe he knows. Excuse me, Your Honor, Judge.
Yes.
What's with those symbols in the hatch near the observatory?
Those three signs above the hatch on the observatory.
They signify offerings. If you want to ask the Oracle about the weather before a long journey, for example, you place the things the Oracle wants in the hatch, and then you're given an audience with it.
Yeah. That's what I imagined.
So the Oracle's an it? Where do I get the offerings from?
The Oracle wants some unusual things.
Oh, that's often the case. It's a strange being, and quite unabashed. We wanted to ban it from the island, but every time we tried, it prophesied what dreadful consequences that would have, and so we left it be.
Where do I get the things from?
Yeah.
All the shops are closed. There was a a kind of accident.
Kind of?
And the inhabitants of the island are temporarily out of town.
Well, that's what you call it.
I keep an eye on their things, as their trustworthy and reliable leader. So don't even think about stealing anything, will you?
Wouldn't dream of it.
How's the trial going?
How's the trial going?
Marvelously. The accused is caught up in a web of contradictions.
This whole thing is ridiculous, and I'm innocent.
You see?
Why are you having this trial in the first place? I didn't realize things were quite so formal with pirates.
Aye, it's a new wind blowing on Tugato. No more impulse punishments. Law and order now rules. So it's safe for anyone to come back to the island.
Is that how lonely you are?
The pirates all mutinied and left, and now he's making out he's some kind of considerate leader.
Silence in court, you spawny wazzock.
He loves that little epithet.
I think I've interrupted the court proceedings long enough.
True.
Critter'll be all right. Won't matter what the outcome. I'm not going to bail him out. Let Critter help him.
Maybe now we can harvest some of these plants?
Potatoes for potato crisps. Well, it's a start. That should do.
We'll have to fry them in the pan.
Potatoes in any shape or form are a pirate's favorite dish. Apparently it's classed as a great honor to peel mountains of potatoes for the ship's cook. Nate used to brag about having spent much of his childhood doing this.
Put them in the pan.
If I want to make crisps, I better cut the potatoes into thin slices first.
With what? So yeah, this is actually the Archmage Alistair.
The Archmage survived the long journey from Seastone to here well. I hope that the Oracle in the House Without Corners can tell me how to change him back. The water's pretty dirty.
I click on the key to look at the key, and she just walks over next to it and just stands there.
Even if I wanted to.
Yeah. Well, the other stuff might be on the ship, which we can use the hook
Medusa
and
rope. Medusa turns every living soul who looks upon her to stone. That's ancient magic, thousands of years old. I'd love to help those poor people, but this magic's very powerful. Back in those days, magic was still wild and untamed.
It's not wild and untamed anymore? Alright, let's go to the harbor. Maybe now she'll take snails?
I'm not sure what sort of coloring should go into one of these energy drinks, but what's to say that purple wouldn't do the trick?
Sorry guys, itch on ear.
Defense strategy doesn't work too well now, does it?
What'd it do? Ninja moves?
Whoa, relax, little guy. I've got what I need. The coloring's going in the bottle.
Huh. Dunk!
The purple secretions of the snails seem almost black at this concentration. As soon as I fill the bottle with water and sugar, the drink should look much lighter.
Perhaps. This doesn't call for salt.
Haven't a clue what happened to the jetty. But I've got a pretty good idea who might have been responsible for it. Perhaps I could find something useful on the Mary.
Exactly what I was thinking.
How do I get over there? I'd like to give Buttercup a well-earned rest.
Elementary, my dear elfkins. Throw the rope with the hook to the Mary. This is not really good for someone who's, like, so pregnant to be doing this. Now, are you going to climb along it or use it as a jump rope? Because I think your balance might be a little off.
It'd be simpler if I could still see my feet.
Yeah, and that too. Cut away, cheesy. New theme. Let's look at the cannon.
After we defeated the Archwitch, we returned to the temple where we'd left Mary. We flew her to Seastone and Nate fired off 3 salute shots. There were only a few injured.
Yeah. Let's look at this knife.
Nate and Critter aren't great believers in order. Ship shapes not to be found here. During my first days on the Mary, I tidied up after them. I soon gave up on that.
Good. Take the knife, because you can use that to cut the potatoes.
Not exactly a knife for fighting. Looks more like a kitchen knife. Not even a sharp one. Okay, I'll cut the slices as thin as I possibly can. Wafer-thin potatoes. A little bowlful. The thin potato slices get put into the pan, like this.
Right.
I've left the skins on. That'll give extra flavour. I've cut the slices as thin as possible.
And we can add salt.
As soon as I've got the cooked potato crisps, I'll be able to salt them. Doesn't make any sense to do it before.
True, we just need fire now. The wheel?
Buttercup's too tired to carry me any further. But I can't just steal the Mary. She and Nate are thick as thieves. She wouldn't obey me.
Besides, we need to get in touch with the Oracle so she can help us change back the Archmage.
Nate did explain the fundamentals of navigation to me. Well, he called it the fundamentals. I'm pretty sure that was all he knew, plus some stuff he made up on the spot to impress me.
What is this? Oh, cloth?
That's Nate's lucky headscarf. He put it on during stormy weather. Critter and I used to poke fun at the fact that it was always a matter of luck every time he stepped behind the wheel.
Take.
That's Nate's favourite headscarf. Or so I believe. He wore it a lot.
Alright, let's check out the cage.
When I saw Nate for the first time, he was sitting in this very cage. The bounty hunter Mazaz had captured him. He managed to convince me that he was a capable captain able to help me. I thought he was brazen and pompous and clumsy and somehow also very sweet.
Yeah.
I shouldn't have got involved with him. The heart's a poor counselor when it comes to matters of love. I don't know what happened to Mazaz. Nate somehow managed to outwit her in the wildlands. Perhaps she managed to capture him after all and brought him here. We didn't fly a direct route from Seastone to the Elf Burrow. We made detours and explored Aventasia. Once we spent 3 days and nights drifting over the ocean because Nate and Wilbur tried to give the engine a bit more power. It was wonderful. The peace, the sea, the moonlight, and the 2 engineers making things worse each day.
What's a pot here?
A sticky looking pot with, some sort of slime. We don't have any machines in the Elf Burrow, but Wilbur told me about how he was responsible for oiling and greasing all the machinery in the gnome hole. I imagine the stuff in this pot is the same sort of thing.
Oh, we need the fat for boiling up the potatoes. I wonder where we're going to find a fire, a heat source.
The pot's half full of fatty grease. Fat is used for cooking, but this? Whatever.
Whatever.
The thinly cut potato slices are sucking up all the fat. And I'm not actually feeling repulsed by the sight. Yeah. Damn pregnancy.
Right. Alright. The place left to go now is down. Yeah, hold on to that thing. Hello, hello?
Princess Ivo, what are you doing here?
Being pregnant.
Hello, Mary.
Are you here to break Captain Nate's heart again?
Excuse me?
Did he tell you that? He left me, just like that.
But that's just ridiculous. He loves you. He left the ship full of hope, and 30 minutes later, he returned a different man. You said no, didn't you?
Huh. Nate wanted to propose to me?
He was going to propose to me that night?
He had a ring and got himself a fine suit from the wardrobe. Yes, a proposal with all the bells and whistles.
I don't think he actually proposed.
He was so nervous. He practiced the whole day. Asked me what I thought at least 100 times.
He didn't ask me once.
He didn't? I was convinced that our sudden departure was down to your refusing him. I said some horrible things about you. But Captain Nate wouldn't stand for it. When he left the cabin carrying the ring, that was the last time I saw him truly happy.
So, wow. Did he... You know, I was about to think, maybe he, chickened out, didn't actually ask her, but you know what? I'm willing to bet Monk is posed as her and told him no for some reason. I mean, nothing to do with them, but somehow furthered his own plot. Not sure exactly how it figures in, but I bet you she said no, but it wasn't her. So what brought you to Tugator?
Why did you come to Tugator?
Captain Nate made a deal with a little bounty hunter in Bonzing. A gnome, I think. I hardly believed it when he gave me the course, but he said it was important. The most important thing in the world.
A wretched magic lamp was the most important thing to him, huh?
When Tugator appeared on the horizon, Nate let the bounty hunter put him in chains.
Right.
Just like I was put in chains by the red pirate when we eventually reached the island.
We have seen that bounty hunter.
The next day, I felt the chain release itself. There was lots of shouting and noise, and ever since, I've wondered what was going on.
And then I came down the stairs.
Exactly. The princess who had given my captain so much heartache. Well, that's what I thought, at least.
He left me. Just like that.
He just disappeared without a word. And I never got a marriage proposal.
But
yeah.
Something must have happened.
We were chipped.
Otherwise, why would he have just left like that?
I woke up and wanted to go to him. But Mother told me that Nate had disappeared in the middle of the night with no explanation. I was sure that it was just a misunderstanding and that he'd come back, but he didn't.
Oh, sweetie. That is simply dreadful.
Maybe his mother's behind her mother's behind it.
Then angry. And after a while I started blaming myself. I'm a modern elf princess. Why am I acting like some silly little girl just because a bloke's left me?
Her mother might be behind it. She really did not want those two to be together. Whatever the reason, Nate should not have just scarpered away from me like that.
Whatever the reason for him running, scarpered. He shouldn't have just turned his back on me without explanation.
Not that I wish to defend him, But do you think he might have got cold feet because of your child?
Well, he didn't know.
Congratulations, by the way.
Thanks.
Oh, it's not his child.
What? You lying harlot. Go all doe-eyed at my Captain Nathan, then go whoring around with someone else. And here's me, gullible Gertie, almost falling for your lies.
Well, Gertie?
Just you wait.
Let's use the Mary.
That's the same reaction Nate had. I have never and would never cheat on him. My pregnancy's a bit of a mystery to me as well.
He didn't know before, he just found out now.
But hey, thanks for your support.
Yeah, really. Alright. Bunch of stuff to look at. Let's look at the oven. See if there's any toilet paper in here.
There's a whole heap of coal glowing in the oven. Perhaps not enough to give Mary some steam, but certainly enough to grill half a pig with strawberry jam and pickled gherkins. Did I really just say that? The glowing coals in the oven are giving out a pleasant warmth.
Or...
the glowing...
enough to fry up some potatoes. I forgot about this oven.
Right. High heat, boiling fat, and thin potato slices. Should work. Oh yes, I can smell it already.
We should help ourselves to a few. Right.
Done. If I didn't know it was just my hormones talking, I could easily eat those.
Oh yeah. Now we could salt them.
Now to add the crowning glory to the crisps. Salt. Ready.
You're ready, Dad.
They look yummy.
Okay. One thing down. Sack of sugar. Oh, we can add that to our formula.
Critter puts huge quantities of sugar in his tea. He gets that from Nate. Neither of them understand the rationale behind drinking tea. One heats water, puts tea into it, and then pretends that it tastes of something.
Pretends.
Sugar and milk are just an interference. A good handful. That should do.
Sugar.
A good handful of the finest sugar. Nate got it directly from the sugarcane fields in Normand.
Put it in the bottle.
A ridiculous amount of sugar. Basis of many drinks. Sugar and colouring are in there already. Just missing some water now.
Unfortunately, you think with a boat there would be lots of water around, but no, this is in the sky. Alright, let's look at the wardrobe.
We had a lot of fun with this wardrobe. Or more precisely with the costumes in it.
Yeah, some pretty interesting stuff in there.
We had fashion shows every evening. Wilbur and Critter looked hilarious. Happy times.
I'd like to see that. Let's search through here.
I'm not going to poke around the wardrobe. Too many memories.
Yeah. We need toilet paper. You never know where you're going to find toilet paper. Let's look at the desk.
Chaos wherever you look. Nate is and always will be a pirate. Nothing's going to change that.
So you won't look at it. Okay. And what about this mirror?
Nate always insisted he hadn't got rid of the Red Pirate's dressing table because it wouldn't fit through the hatch. However, my theory is he'd missed the mirror.
Yeah. When we played this as Nate, he loved admiring himself in the mirror.
Nate always insisted, however...
can we do anything with the mirror? Now look at the mirror.
Nate always insists, however, my...
nope. Alright, I guess we'll look at her.
Mary's just like Nate. She jumps to the wrong conclusion and doesn't even give me a chance to explain myself. It's so unfair.
Yeah, I noticed.
Mary's just like Nate. It's...
well, there's nothing else we can really do around here. We need water for this, and we need toilet paper. Okay, we're out of here. Make sure there isn't anything else that we could see. Nope. Disembark the ship. That's gotta be extremely difficult while pregnant. Come on. We need water. Oh, there's water in here, duh. So I have no idea where to find toilet paper from. I could find a substitute. Right then, the bottle is full. Sometimes she loses her words.
You won't catch me drinking this stuff, but the ingredients are exactly the same as the original drink. The Oracle should accept this, I hope.
Alright, we've got two things. We just need toilet paper. Oops, she's getting stuck. Frame rate hit.
Critter will be alright. Won't matter what the outcome. He didn't even hear me out. He simply disappears.
Toilet paper.
Excuse me, Your Honor.
Yes.
No.
I think I've interrupted the...
True.
Well... let's go up here. At least we got two of these things. Toilet roll.
Strange offerings.
Mm.
It appears that I have strange... That's that, then.
Crisps.
Just missing some toilet paper now.
What if we do this instead?
That's Nate's favorite headscarf. I couldn't, could I?
Yeah. Would it work?
Have fun with it.
Is it close enough?
All huh? Right then. Open Sesame.
Open Saskatchewan. Open Sasquatch.
Are you taking the I'm gonna do cool, and you can it up your you. I'm sorry. I really shouldn't be getting so excited. Let's try that once again. If you don't open this door this instant, I will personally ensure that this building is smashed onto the rocks 3,000 meters below us.
You better believe
then,
it.
Then, I will set fire to everything on this island and allow the island to crush your broken body.
You better let her
that,
in.
And after that, I'll get angry. I see we understand each other.
Yeah, there we go.
I don't go into the attic, oh, you stupid cow!
Oh, my God.
Oh, yes. Strawberry tart.
What?
Don't go there, honey. He's only gonna cheat on you.
He was watching us from
so
all these mirrors.
You are this oracle?
Good guess, Princess Ivo.
You're much shorter in real life.
Is this the one we talked through the fountain? The fountain or the thing of water? We had to combine three different kinds of water at the beginning of the game to talk to this thing or a voice in the well. What's this nonsense of the offerings about?
What's this about offerings? Do you think I'm going to be your errand girl?
Nah, be afraid.
You already have been.
Be very afraid.
I can't leave this room. I offer a valuable service, and someone has to do my shopping.
I bring...
No, not that door! Right!
So, the pirates have provided you with everything you need to survive?
Correct. But then, the red pirate went crazy and scared them all off the island. That's why I have to make do with coloured sugar water and disgusting crisps.
You ate that?
I had to. I have needs, you know. Oh, yes. Mario without a prenup. That's a great idea.
What role are you playing in all this?
You told me in the Elfborough that I would come here. So you can see into the future. What's your game?
The mirrors show the future. Or possible versions of the future.
Then why didn't you warn Wilbur or the Archmage what was going to happen?
No one asked.
How could I get their attention? Anyway, I only observe. I don't get involved. Oh, let him cry. He deserves it.
You're getting involved now.
But only because it's absolutely necessary. Oh, a boat! We're saved!
Was that one mirror about Gilligan's Island? I've got the Archmage here with me, as you presumably know already.
I've got the frog. The Archmage.
I saw the battle! Spectacular! That little girl and Wilbur's wand. You couldn't make it up.
I guess not.
Is there a way of changing Master Alistair back?
Oh, that's not so easy. He hasn't just been turned into a frog. He is a frog now. Oh, don't go, Johnny! She needs you!
But he can be changed back, can't he?
Perhaps. His consciousness and his soul are in another place. But there is still a weak bridge connecting him to this world.
So there is hope?
Yes, but just a vague one. You have to... Wallop! Right between the eyes! That had to hurt!
Can I trust you?
Oh, that's all well and good. The question is, can I trust you?
What kind of a question is that? No matter what I say, you still won't know.
True.
Maybe you're just telling me these things because you're bored and want to create a bit of chaos.
There are always exciting things happening in this world. I just want it to stay that way.
What do you mean?
Turn the Archmage back to normal. He can tell you.
I'd love to turn him back to normal. So, speaking of which, how do I help him?
How can we return the spirit of the Archmage to this world?
The Red Pirate has a magic compass. It always points in the direction of what you desire most. In the case of the Archmage, this is hopefully a way back. The Lost Book of the Dead explains how to summon a spirit back into this world. But without a spark of life, he would die as soon as he returned.
Well, that wouldn't be good.
A magic compass, a lost book, and a spark of life. Doesn't sound like a walk in the park.
That's why I lured you here.
Oh, no.
What?
Not him. No.
You need them, Ivo. You won't manage this task without them.
Yeah. I'm perfectly able to get a hold of these three things on my own.
I will get these three things and change the Archmage back. On my own.
No, you won't. I've seen a future in which you fail, Ivo. A future that you won't live to see.
Oh, but that's only one possible future.
True, but are you prepared to risk its occurrence just because Nate gets on your nerves?
Yes.
He doesn't just get on my nerves.
I know, it's... What? That's never a valuable antique.
Focus here, brain dude. We know where the compass and the spark of life are. You do? But where's the book?
You said that the Book of the Dead had disappeared. Are there any clues to where it is?
Well, it's in a place without mirrors. That much is clear. It was kept in the legendary desert city of Lorem Ipsum in the Umzu Desert. No more is known.
Hmm. Lorem Ipsum? Now, where have I heard of that?
No idea.
An ancient city that finally lost the battle against the sand.
I'll find it, and the Book of the Dead.
The two of you will find the town.
Three. Critter. Very well. If it's absolutely necessary, I'll take that idiot and critter in tow.
Very well. I'll get both of them out of there.
It's not that easy. You're forgetting the head.
The head?
The head of Medusa.
Oh, that head.
I've seen it. Fortunately, just through my mirrors. It's terrible. If you try to rescue Nate and the critter with all guns blazing, the Red Pirate will unveil the head, and then no magic in the world can save you.
Got any suggestions?
You have to win the court hearing.
Would that not strike you as somewhat improbable with that judge?
Not with the right defense strategy. I haven't heard that one before.
Hello? Stick to the point.
How can I convince the Red Pirate of Nate's innocence?
How am I going to convince the Red Pirate of Nate's innocence? Considering the fact that I'm pretty certain that there's a case to answer on every single count.
Of course Nate did everything he's accused of. But was it his free will?
What do you mean?
Say someone is controlled by a voodoo curse and kills someone. Is he the murderer or the one controlling the doll? I wouldn't eat that salad.
What have voodoo dolls got to do with Nate and the theft of the lamp?
Act as his defense lawyer and tell the Red Pirate that Nate was controlled by a higher power. The rest will follow of its own accord.
Oh, really?
That's insane.
Trust me, I can see through all mirrors. And anyway, I love courtroom dramas.
Okay, I'm just going to go now.
Shh! He's proposing to her.
Well, thanks for your help.
I have some stuff to look at, and then we can leave and go back out and try to win a courtroom thing. Thanks for watching. See you next time, and a bang bang boogie, and don't stop the boogie.